Nowadays, the entire world is facing a problem called COVID-19. So during this period, we are all instructed to stay back at home. Then only we can win over this COVID-19. And nowadays, many videos are getting viral. In that, even government is also instructing the public to wash the hands after every 1 hour. Why we have to wash the hands with the soaps or detergents? Do you know the reason? You would have studied this in class 10th. In the chapter of hydrocarbons, the soaps and detergent part, actually the soap is forming micelles. So these micelles will have one head and one tail, and the tail is having one kind of property. The head is having another kind of property, hydrophobic and hydrophilic. So when all tails are coming together, that means they will be acquiring certain, what kind of thing we call it as? Why they repel? Fine, you will get the answer in this topic. So let me introduce by doing some activities this lesson. Yes, I got Hari Vaidya has said that it is charge. Fine, it is charge. So now we are going to introduce the electric charges. So let me do some activities first for you, and then we will talk about these electric charges further. I have placed some thermocol balls. I hope that everyone can see these thermocol balls. Now what I do, I'll take one plastic straw. When I rub the plastic straw with the silk cloth, what happens? Let's see. Now you see, I'm just rubbing the plastic straw with the silk cloth. So you would have observed that this attracts these thermocol balls. So I placed some thermocol balls, and then after that I rubbed this plastic straw with the help of a silk cloth, and then this starts attracting the thermocol balls. Now you can see the thermocol balls are getting released. They are moving away from the plastic ball. Already some 3-4 have got down. What could be the reason for it? So that is the homework for you. You have to find out the answer for it. Why after attracting, after some time, these balls are falling down. Okay. Now let me show you another demonstration. Now I will again rub this plastic straw, and I kept it on this stand. Okay. Now I'll take another plastic straw. Again, I am rubbing with the same silk cloth. Now see what happens. So you have clearly observed this rose color straw does not like this green color straw. So that's why the green color straw is moving away. Is it the reason that green and rose are enemies? Let me do it once again for you. So it is completely moving away. Now I'll do, this is my ebonite rod and this is my cat fur. It is in fact the lady's purse. This one. Now I rub with this cat fur to this ebonite rod. And let's see what happens. See, it is attracted. See, what's the reason? This black color, this green color is liking this black. whereas it does not like this pink. Is it the reason for it? So in the first case, you have seen that the two straws are repelling each other. You can see the repulsion. Okay. I think these activities are enough to introduce our topic. So the very first question I asked you, that why do we use soap to wash our hands? Once the thermocol balls are attracted towards the straw, but after some time they are moving away from the straw. What could be the reason? In your lower classes also, you would have performed these kind of activities. So in that activities, you have seen already the force of attraction and force of repulsion. So that is the same idea I have done here. In fact, he is the first person who has done these experiments way back 600 BC. Listen to it carefully, 600 BC. That means these people have already have an idea about this kind of charges in 600 BC. So he is Thales. Now after that, I'll show one figure. Try to identify. What is this? No, this I have shown something to you on the screen. What is this? Yes, it is dollar, American dollar. So whose picture it is? Benjamin Franklin. Very good. So he is Benjamin Franklin. Then by the way, whose picture will be available, is there on our Indian currency notes? Have you ever seen the Indian currency? I didn't get the reply. This is American dollar. On American dollar, Benjamin Franklin's figure is there. Now, whose figure? Mahatma Gandhi. Okay. So, Mahatma Gandhi's figure is there in our Indian currency. Okay. Both are great people. Benjamin Franklin as well as Mahatma Gandhi, both are very great people. Now, what is the contribution of Benjamin Franklin? He has taken several things and rubbed with several other things, and then he has established that there could be two different charges. Now our lesson is electric charges. Electric charges. I hope that you can see this clearly. Now, not only electric charges. So, in your class 9th, you would have studied the different kinds of forces. There are some forces which are contact forces. There are some forces which, even without coming in contact also, the force can be acting between the two substances. So, the simplest example that you would have played with magnets at your home, you would have observed that even without making them to contact with each other, they used to repel. Or if you keep some north pole nearer to the south pole, they used to attract. That is called non-contact forces. Here, without touching the straw, I was able to move the straw. That means some force must be, because Newton says unless and until some unbalanced force acts on the object, it cannot move. The straw was moving. When the straw was moving, means certainly the one force must be acting on it. The force is called electrostatic force. Now we have to study first electric charges. Now let me show you. I think you will be able to see this. Now let me switch off the light. Now you see, if I keep my hand here, which occasion you will see these kind of things? Lightning, very good. So when lightning, these kind of things are there. What is lightning actually? When two highly charged clouds colliding with each other, then they produce these kind of light and a sound. Of course, light will be visible first, sound will be heard next, because the speed of light is more than that of speed of sound. Now what, my purpose is not to show this design to you. The purpose is something different. I would like to introduce some other, that is nothing but electric field. Now see, I did not touch this one, but I am able to light this neon bulb. So what makes it to glow? There should be some invisible quantity must be passing through it. So that invisible quantity we call it as electric field. So now our topic is electric charges and electric field. To define charge. So charge is defined, just for the sake of definition, as it is inherent property of the object by virtue of which the electric field or electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion is caused. So now first we talk about charges and later we talk about electric field. So now you have seen that there is some force in some cases, and in some other cases there is repulsion. Okay, why it is so? As you have experienced already in your childhood, the repulsion is there between two like poles. When you play with the magnets, the repulsion is there with the like poles and attraction is there with the unlike poles. Same is the case in the case of electric charges also. So now electric charges can be named as positive and negative. If the substance is able to release electrons, then it will get positive charge. If the substance is able to get the electrons, then we have the negative charge in it. So this concept was not known to Benjamin Franklin, but he named simply positive and negative. Why he made like that? Because when I rubbed this straw with this silk cloth, you have seen that it gets one kind of charge and it gets another kind of charge. When these two are placed together, then again they become neutral. So when equal positive and negative charges are there, it becomes again neutral. So he would have imagined that, because by the time he knows the number theory, what number line will explain us, there will be zero at the center, and then here positive, positive 1, positive 2, and so on, and here negative 1, negative 2, and so on. If you add positive 1 and negative 1, you will get 0. If you add positive and negative, you will get 0. That is the idea behind naming these two charges as positive, as negative. But the modern physics in 19th century, once it is discovered the charge of the electron by Millikan oil drop method, then we have come to know that these electrostatic or electric charges are generally just because of losing the electrons, that is positive, gaining the electrons, that is negative. So when we keep one positive charge and one negative charge, because he has done a lot of activities, and out of all activities he could find that there could be two different charges. That I can show it to you. I have already shown, I suppose, when I took two straws then and rubbed by silk, then I got the same charge. So this is also acquiring the same one kind of charge. This is also acquiring another same kind of charge. Therefore, when I place this one, immediately it got rotated. But whereas when I have rubbed with fur, so this is fur. When I rubbed with fur this ebonite rod, then it was attracting it. That means certainly whatever the charge is placed on this, and this charge acquired by rubbing the fur on the ebonite rod are two entirely different charges. Therefore, it starts attracting this one. So, Benjamin Franklin finally concluded that there could be two types of charges, and he randomly named one kind of charge as A, the other kind of charge as B. Repulsion is the surest test to find the nature of charges. Why repulsion? Because if I take only one positive charge, if I keep it nearer to the neutral objects, that activity also I have shown it to you. So I have taken thermocol balls and I rubbed this one. I did not do anything with it. Then when I keep this one, then it starts getting attracted. So here it is neutral object. So a charged object can attract neutral object, or it can attract the charge of opposite nature. So that's why you cannot say that attraction is the test for it. So we do not know. You cannot come to that conclusion. Suppose it acquires positive charge, and if I keep it nearer to this one and it is getting attracted, it does not mean that these thermocol balls are already having negative charge. So I cannot confirm whether it is negatively charged objects or neutral. So attraction is not the test to be done. What repulsion? So repulsion, only it is possible when the two are charged objects. If any one of them is not charged objects, it is purely attracting. If two are having the same nature of charges, then only it repels. Okay, so this is all about the discovery of charges, and then why they are named like that. But modern concept can clearly say that if the object loses electrons, immediately it gets positive charge, and if the object gains electrons, it gets negative charge. When equal amount of positive and negative are added, then it becomes neutral. So this symbolic, this one I took white as positive, black as negative, red as neutral. Now what we have to do is how this name for this, what is the branch of physics that deals with it? That is known as static electricity. What do you mean by static? It is nothing but at rest. And electricity word is coined from the amber. The Greek meaning of amber is electron. So amber is nothing but an yellowish stone. Of course, it's not amber. It looks like this. So even this also allows this properties of attraction and repulsion. I can rub it and I can place it nearer to the thermocol balls. But if you refer that what is an amber, amber is just nothing but an yellowish stone which is translucent. It is representing all the properties, but it is not exactly the amber. So the meaning of amber in English is electron. So from electron, this electric name has come. So static electricity is the present day's, I mean today's topic. Okay, so now the thing is, we have to learn further. Suppose if the charge, till now we have discussed the nature of charges. Okay, fine. So suppose if electrons are lost, then we have the positive. And then if electrons are gained by any object, then we say that it is negative. It's fine. So far, so good. Now, how do you find the amount of charge? And in class 11th only, I told you that whenever we define and we come across any physical quantity, then you have to define it. So now this electric charge is the new physical quantity that you have come across, and then electric field. We will talk just little later about electric field, but electric charge, it is inherent property of the object or of the body or of the substance by virtue of which electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion is caused. Okay, that is the definition of it. Now we have to give the units for it. The units is coulomb. As you have already studied chemistry class 11th, you know already the units of charge is coulomb, and this is the symbol for it, C. Now you have to say, specify whether it is a vector or scalar. It is a scalar. Okay, then next you have to write the coulomb is a very big unit. What is the charge of an electron? E is equal to negative times 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. One electron charge is this much, 10 to the power of minus 19. You should give attention to this minus 19. Now, in class 10th, there was a problem. How many electrons we have to put together so that it becomes one coulomb? The answer, how do we do? Can anyone give the answer directly? How many electrons are there in one coulomb charge? 6.24 × 10⁻¹⁸. Okay, we will come back whether this answer is correct or not. Okay, now I'll tell you how many electrons will be accommodated here, because just now we are going to discuss the properties of charges. In that I'll tell you. Now we have to write the 6.25 × 10⁻¹⁸ is correct. That's good. 6.25 × 10⁻¹⁸ electrons are there. See, that much of electrons are placed at one particular place. Then it gives us one coulomb charge. So these many electrons are required. Now we have to write the dimensional formula for it. So we have studied in class 11th, there are seven fundamental quantities. So those seven fundamental quantities, charge is not one among them. So what are the other fundamental quantities which are related to electricity? Can anyone give the reply? We have studied seven fundamental quantities in class 11th, in the first topic. And in that, a particular quantity is related to electricity. What it is? Current. And ampere is its unit. Okay. So now we have to write. Well, how did we define current in lower classes? Current is nothing but charge passing per unit time. So we write I is equal to Q by T, or charge Q is equal to I times T. So I we write A to the power of 1 and T to the power of 1. So M0, there is no mass terms here, L0, A1, T1. So this is the dimensional formula for the charge. So till now we have covered what is electric charge, then whether it is scalar or vector, then we have defined the charge, electric charge. Even though it's not exact the definition, it's very tough to define electric charge and mass also. And after that, we have seen that some properties like charges repel, unlike charges attract. Now let me ask you a question. Suppose Q1 is one charge. We do not know what nature it is, what kind of charge it is, and Q2 is the another charge. If I say that it is greater than zero, then what kind of force will be there in between these two? The second question, Q1, Q2 is less than zero, then what kind of force? Now this is product. Q1, Q2 is equal to zero. What kind of force is there between these two. Can anyone discuss the answer for it? Now the thing is, here Q1, Q2 is greater than 0. That means if it is to be more than 0, okay, I got some answers. Electrostatic force is there, of course. Whether it is force of attraction or force of repulsion, that I wanted. Okay, let me discuss. When Q1, Q2 is greater than 0, mathematically we know that the product of two positive quantities or the product of two negative quantities will always give the result as greater than 0. That means these two must be of the same nature. When the two charged particles are placed of the same nature, the first one will be repulsive. Why? Because this is positive, this is positive, then only it can be more than 0. If it is negative, it should also be negative, then only it should be greater than 0. So therefore, here repulsive. What about the second case? When Q1, Q2 is less than 0, here if Q1 is positive, Q2 must be negative. If Q2 is positive, Q1 must be negative. That means you will get the product only when the two different signs of quantities are multiplied. Therefore, it should be attractive. Yes, some of you are very right, attractive. Now, what should be the answer for the last one? Mathematically, we say Q1, Q2 is equal to 0 means either Q1 is equal to 0. 0 here, I take that it is neutral. Or Q2 is equal to 0. Or both are zeros. Q1 and Q2. So if Q1, Q2 is 0, suppose it is having positive charge, let us suppose, and it is neutral, then what about the product? 0 only. Okay. So in that case, it attracts, because every charged object will attract the uncharged objects. That's what we have seen. These thermocol balls were uncharged, and then I charged that plastic straw. Then plastic straw was able to attract these thermocol balls. So this is one. The other condition may be, suppose it can be 0, but it is positive. In that case, what happens? This will attract this one. So then also it is attraction. Suppose, what about the third option? If Q1, Q2 both are zeros, then both are neutral objects. If both are neutral, they cannot attract each other, but there is always a force of attraction. What kind of that force? Certainly, this is having certain mass. This is also, even though it's very minute, and this is also having some mass. These two are neutral charged particles. Then in that case, would you say that there is no force of attraction or repulsion, or some force is there? Good. Gravitational force. So there is gravitational force of attraction always, even though it is very lesser when compared to the electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion. So gravitational force of attraction is there. So in this, all the three cases will give us attraction. Once again, let me tell you that repulsion is only the surest test, not attraction, because attraction is possible between two different nature of charges. Attraction is there, but attraction is also possible between a neutral and a charged object. Okay, so if I rub this one for longer period of time, will it be more charge? Suppose if I rub for once, will it get more charge? So to do all these things, there are some apparatus. So the apparatus are, you would have studied in your lower classes. I think you would have heard the name gold leaf electroscope. This is the gold leaf electroscope. So this is gold leaf electroscope. Now here you can see that here, of course, it's made up of aluminum foils. So two aluminum foils are there, and that is connected by a metal rod and a disk is placed over it. Now if I place any charged object here, then you will see that this will be diverged, because suppose if I keep the positive charge here, then the electrons will come towards this one, and then by virtue of which, because electrons will be attracted towards positive charge. Let me explain it again. See, this is positive charge. If I keep one positive charge here, what happens? The electrons from the lower part will come and be attracted to this positive charge. Okay. Now, these two leaves will acquire negative charge because, positive charge again, because these negative electrons are coming out towards the disk. Therefore, positive space is left out there. So, both the foils will have positive charge. Therefore, they repel and the divergence is observed. Now, you can have one scale. Is it visible? One scale is there inside. So, through that scale, you will be able to study this curved portion. You will be able to identify the angle of divergence, and from which you can understand whether the charge is more in the first case or whether the charge is more in the second case. Okay, this gives you a qualitative idea only, not quantitative idea. Okay, so this is gold leaf electroscope. Even you can prepare your own gold leaf electroscope at your homes. So simply take any metal rod like this. Okay, now you take one aluminum foil and put it over this curve, and then you rub the straw with silk and put it here. Then you will see that there will be a divergence. So this divergence can be observed. The degree of divergence will give you roughly, qualitatively, which charge is more, which charge is less. That only we can find out. But if you calibrate that for particular charge, then we can compare. Okay. So, but that calibration is required. So, this is first one, gold leaf electroscope. Prepare this. You would have prepared in class 7th, I suppose. So, if you have not prepared, better prepare this one and enjoy. Because when we do the things and we get the results that are taught in the classroom, then you will have some aesthetic sense in it. I mean, you will feel very happy. Pleasure observing the things. Now, the other one is this one. So this is called pith ball electroscope. We know that electro means related to charge, scope means vision. To measure the electrostatic charge, we make use of these kind of things. So here, this is called, these two are called pith balls. How to measure this one? Again, this will also give us the qualitative idea only, not quantitative idea. Now here, I'll just do the same. I hope that you are able to see this pith ball electroscope. See? Later on, you just give me the feedback through your WhatsApp whether the activities are clearly visible to you or not, so that I can make some arrangements to show it properly. See, here what I have done, why the two balls are separated? Because they got the same charge on it. When they get same charge, they will be repelling with each other. Okay, so this is called pith ball electroscope. Now the third one is proof plane. It's not mentioned in your textbook, of course. Proof plane is nothing but we give one particular charge, known charge, to the some surface. So this I have taken as a surface and I give the charge now. How do I give the charge? Is there any method to give the charge? Rubbing. Rubbing with what? Suitable substance. So I am rubbing this. So I get the charge on this. Better you take silk cloth. Any cloth means sometimes it may not give proper results, but silk cloth is okay. All these electrostatic demonstrations will be failed in rainy season or winter season. Okay, so now what I'll do, see, are you able to see the change in the pith balls? If I remove, it's there. I'll give a bit more charge. See how the two are repelled. They are repelling each other. Why they are repelling each other, I'll tell you. We'll have to discuss that in the next topic. See, clearly the repulsion is more between the two. So this is proof plan. So we have studied about charges and we now could come to know how to measure them qualitatively but not quantitatively. Quantitative measurements can be done with the help of, can anyone give the answer? How do we calculate the charges? What is the simplest experiment that we do normally in lower classes through which we are able to understand the quantifying the charges? Can anyone give the answer? That experiment you would have either seen or would have conducted by yourself. No idea? Come up with some answers. Because had it been a regular interactive class, it should be an interactive. What is this? Why this? So this is the class for today. Hopefully that you will read this lesson from the NCERT textbook and you will come back.